Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. O mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
The Lord be with you. reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. After he had been acclaimed by crowds, Jesus entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. He looked all around him, but as it was now late, he went out to Bethany with 12. Next day, as they were leaving Bethany, he felt hungry. Seeing a fig tree leaf some distance away, he went to see if he could find any fruit on it. But when he came up to it, he found nothing but leaves, for it was not the season for figs. And he addressed the fig tree. "May no one ever eat fruit from you again," he said. And his disciples heard him say this. So they reached Jerusalem, and he went into the temple and began driving out those who were selling and buying there. He upset the tables of the money changers and the chairs of those who were selling pigeons. Nor would he allow anyone to carry anything through the temple. And he taught them and said, "Does not Scripture say, 'My house will be called a house of bread for all the peoples'? But you have turned it into a robber's den." This came to the ears of the chief priests and the scribes, and they tried to find some way of doing away with him. They were afraid of him, because the people were carried away by his teaching. And when evening came, he went out of the city. Next morning, as they passed by, they saw the fig tree withered to the roots. Peter remembered, "Look, Rabbi," he said to Jesus, "the fig tree you cursed has withered away." Jesus answered, "Have faith in God. I tell you solemnly, if anyone says to this mountain, 'Get up and throw yourself into the sea,' with no hesitation in his heart, but believing that what he says will happen, it will be done for him. I tell you therefore, everything you ask and pray for, believe that you have it already, and it will be yours. And when you stand in prayer, forgive whatever you have against anybody, so that your Father in heaven may forgive your failures too. But if you do not forgive, your Father in heaven will not forgive your failings either." The Gospel. Forgiveness nourishes our prayer. Prayer is something that many might struggle with. When we come to a deep faith in Christ, we want to grow closer and we want to know how to pray. But oftentimes, this can be a struggle and many can give up after good intentions begin to fade away. Though there are many things that could be said about prayer, the Gospel we heard today highlights one of the greatest obstacles to a healthy prayer life. The obstacle Jesus speaks of is the lack of forgiveness. When we come to Christ in prayer, we need to first cleanse our hearts if we are to hear him speak. And if we come to them while holding on to a grievance towards somebody else, this is an obstacle that must be dealt with first. In fact, if we hold on to that grievance and try to pray, our prayer will most likely not be very effective. Just before this part of the Gospel, we heard the story of Jesus cleansing the temple. He turned over tables and drove the merchants out because they were desecrating the temple by their greed. We should see this story to also be a story about our own souls. Our souls are temples of God, and Jesus does not want sin in our soul. In fact, he wants to root it out with a passion and with much zeal. The goal is to let him do this and to let him cleanse our souls of sin, especially the sin of a lack of forgiveness. Doing so will allow our souls to become places of prayer and worship. Reflect today upon whether you want to grow in prayer. If you do, then start by cleansing your heart of all sin. Confession is the best way to do this. Start by looking at any sin of anger or a lack of forgiveness. By choosing to forgive and letting go of anger, you are allowing Jesus to drive this vice out of your soul. The result will be that you are in a much better place to invite Christ to make your heart his dwelling place. With that done, your prayer life will greatly increase. Let us remember all travelers, especially migrants, refugees, and stateless persons, that the Lord may keep them in his care and lead them to shelter and security. Lord, hear us. We include in our prayer all who are afflicted with physical or mental illness, that having shared in Christ's suffering, they may also rejoice and be glad when his glory is revealed. Lord, hear us. God, our Father, you alone are good. Guide the course of world events. Hear our petitions made in faith and hope. Grant them in the name of Jesus the Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness to receive the vine made of you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread. Yes.
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faithful Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Protection against wickedness and sins of the devil. May God rebuke you.